morning, and welcome to another Good Morning with Jada, Soul via Soul HIIT workout. Today's workout is actually going to be an upper body focused workout. So, again, you can use this in isolation, or if you have more time, you can string some workouts together. Do the upper body with the lower body, or do the core with the upper body, or just do the upper body. So that's what the focus will be today. Still a 15-minute HIIT session, 15 different exercises, and not a huge time commitment, no equipment needed. So let's get warmed up. Alrighty, let's rotate the upper body. Twist and wake it up. Awesome. Take it down. Wonderful. All right, we're going to do some air squats. Grateful for. Other side. Scoop it up. Awesome. One more each side. One more. Scoop up all of our blessings. Wonderful. All right, we're going to walk it down and do some push-ups. You can modify those by being on your knee if you want to. And then go right into a downward dog. And walk the dog back and forth. Good. Walk it back up. Stretch it up. A couple of back lunges to balance. Good, other side. Wonderful. We're doing some jumping jacks to warm up the whole body. Position. Our arms go IYT. So get down in Superman position. Arms come up. Arms go to a Y. And then out to a T. And then rest. Come up. I. Out to a Y. Out to a T, down, I, Y, T, good, rest. Again, this is all upper body focused today. The next one is going to be a side plank. We've done these before. We're going to stay just on one side for the entire time, and then later on we'll do the other side. So get in position. Elbow and shoulder in alignment. Good. Come up. Go up a bite. Arm up. So to add another element on this one, if we rotate and then up. We're going to incorporate a little bit more shoulder. So let's do that. Modified is to be on your knee, but you can still do the same movement to get the upper body involved. Awesome. The next one are old-fashioned push-ups. You can modify this on your knee. You could do it on another level or against a wall if you can't be on your knees at all. I'm going to do a standard military press, but modify as you need to. Remember, flat back, high knee down. Good. All right, our metabolic, or the part that gets our heart rate going, is going to be high knee punches, and we're going to do that throughout the whole workout. That's going to be our metabolic. High knee punches, and really punch those arms. Catch your breath. Push-ups are hard. Here we go. Get the high knees going, and then punch. Really drive those arms. Punch, punch, punch. You can even alternate like with an uppercut. Forward punch. Uppercut. Forward punch. Keep alternating. Incorporate different arm muscles. Good. Catch your breath. Whew. I'm already out of breath. All right, the next one, side plank, other side. So whatever you did the first time, switch it. Here we go. And then add the twist. Twist. Awesome. Okay. We're going to do a push-up variation. We're going to go from diamond to wide. So what that means is when you put your hands together, you're going to come close together and form a diamond, do a push-up that way, and then we're going to go wider than normal and do a push-up. Back to diamond, back to wide. Start with diamond. And again, you can modify this and go to your knees if needed. Totally fine. Diamond push-ups are really hard. Maintain proper form. Good. Awesome. Okay, this next one is a tricep workout, and we're gonna do both sides. I'll tell you halfway and we'll switch. But basically, You use this arm to push up and do a little dip. It's kind of tricky. It's a subtle little move, but you're using the arm on the ground, the hand on the ground, to just slightly lift your body weight. 3 more seconds of the switch. You'll feel a little burn in your tricep area. It is tricky though. We'll do another tricep one though as well. But this is a subtle little move. Good. All right, back to high knee punches. Get that heart rate up. We're gonna do the variation again with the uppercut and then the forward punch. So get your high knees going and then we add in the arms. Here we go. High knees, add the arms, uppercut. Forward punch. Uppercut. Really drive those arms. Forward punch. Uppercut. Forward punch. Good. Whew. Catch your breath. Whew. This next one is called a body saw. You're gonna get in forearm plank position and then we're gonna rock our bodies forward and back. High knee down, flat back. And then rock your body forward and back. Good. Breathe. Good. Again, find those little movements that create a lot of growth in our muscles. Okay, the next one is a bear crawl. So you're going to get in a hovered plank position. You crawl forward and then you crawl back. You want to keep your high knee down and stay low like a bear. So hover position, crawl, 2, 3, back, 2, 3, forward and back. Good, stay low. Hover position the whole time. It's a great core workout too. Stay low, keep crawling. Good. The next one we're gonna do dips, get those triceps again. So you're gonna need like a chair or a higher surface. I'm gonna use this rock because it's what I got. So step your feet out. The farther your feet go, the harder it is. The closer they're into your body, a little bit less stress. Make sure that your elbows and your shoulders stay in alignment. Again, you can walk it out to make it a little harder. Slow and controlled. Good. Those are hard. All right, back to high knee punches. Again, we're gonna alternate uppercut to forward punch. Time to get that heart rate back up. Surprisingly, dips and push-ups though do jack your heart rate, so it's okay if you're breathing heavy now. That's good. Great. Okay. Get the legs going. Add the arms. Uppercut. punch. Really get those high knees. Uppercut. Forward punch. Uppercut. Whew, awesome. All right. Catch your breath. The next one, even though we're really gonna be focusing on upper body, it's also a core and a metabolic. Oh, I gotta catch my breath. We're gonna go plank jacks. We're gonna get forearm position, legs come out and in. Like this. An alternate is to just step it side to side. Keep your high knee down and a flat back. Or you can alternate. Do a few jumps, do a few side steps. Good. All right, the next one is a plank tap. So we're gonna be in upper forearm, or sorry, straight arm plank. We're gonna tap our shoulders side to side. Keep your body as still as possible when you do this. I'll go this way. Plank position, high knee down. Tap, tap. Feet shoulder width apart. If your feet are a little wider, it provides a little bit more stability. Breathe. Tap it. Really limit the motion of your body as you tap. Good job. All right. And the last one, burpee push-up combo. So we're gonna do a burpee into a push-up and then up again. You can modify this if you need to. I don't wanna hit my head on a rock. Okay, here we go. Burpee, push-up, jump back up, up. Jump it up. You got it, keep going. You can modify this by just walking it out and walking it back up, totally fine. Good job. I'm out of breath. Okay, take it down. All right. Catch your breath. Feel your breath coming in and out. Good, slow it down. Wonderful. A few deep belly breaths. Hold. Exhale. Again, inhale. Hold. Exhale. One more. Inhale. Hold. Okay, close your eyes. First of all, a huge thank you to yourself for nourishing your body with exercise. Exercise is nourishment for our body and our mind. It helps relieve anxiety. It helps elevate our mood. Of course, it helps with cardiovascular fitness and fat burn and muscle tone. It is
medicine. So thank yourself for committing to loving yourself and practicing some self-care. I like to call this soul care. Because it's more than just self-care. It's really taking care of the soul of us. This part of mindfulness, stilling your mind, quieting the thoughts, and just being present is something you can learn to do and cultivate that stillness wherever you go. So think about the ways you're going to practice soul care today. This counts as one, so check that out, box. Have a fabulous day. Fill your day with intentional love and grace.